no time, your hands are always full, and you are getting really hangry. This is a story of a mom's life, especially a breastfeeding mom's life. I mean, the amount of calories that we need to consume and the amount of time that we have just don't really balance out. So here are 5 food ideas that I think would be really helpful for you. They're quick, they're easy, they're pretty much healthy, but not like so healthy that they're crazy, ridiculously hard to make or weird ingredients that you don't have in your cupboards right now. So here they are. Let's start with breakfast. Number one, bars. Like, let's be honest, bars are quick and easy, and when you're trying to get other kids fed, whether you're breastfeeding an infant like me and have a toddler sitting at the table saying, more, more, there's just not a lot of time to make something. So sometimes a bar is the best thing first thing in the morning. Some advice about bars are they can be full of a lot of sugar, and so sometimes they seem like healthy by the wrapper. Really check what the ingredients are. Some bars that I really like are like RX bars, and there are other brands that are kind of similar to that. But the basic thing is that they really have simple ingredients like some kind of egg, a nut, and then usually dates to make them sweet. But they're not full of a bunch of like high fructose corn syrup and things like that. So really read the labels. I know it's more expensive to buy the healthier bars, but there are different kind of like bargain stores. We go to a store that's like, this is at its expiration date. I mean, the food is still good. It's a bar, for goodness sakes. But there are ways to find those things cheaper, but I think it's worth the investment when that is literally going to be your breakfast. So look for higher protein and fats and lower sugar content, especially like added sugar. So that's my first tip. Another breakfast idea is overnight oats. And I know this was all the rage for a while, and you saw tons of pictures on Pinterest about like, here's my cute little mason jar of overnight oats. But the truth is they really are a great option for busy moms. So you kind of have to be a little bit of a planner to make this work, because you do have to make them the night before, hence the name overnight oats, right? But if you are a planner, it's something you can make the night before after the kids are sleeping, hopefully, and just eat quick in the morning. And the other thing I really like about them is if you're avoiding dairy, you could put in other substitutes like almond milk or cashew milk or different things like that. You can add collagen if you're using any type of a collagen for like just recovery and skin or protein. Like, collagen has all those things in it, so you can easily mix that into your overnight oats. And then you can add fruit, or you can add like cacao powder, or you can add a lot of stuff, nuts if you like the crunch, to kind of tailor it to what you like. Make it as sweet or as salty as you really like. But, and plus, oatmeal is great for milk production if you are breastfeeding. The third thing that I think is important is, and an easy tip for moms, is a quick lunch. Never underestimate the power of a sandwich or a wrap. Like, I know that sometimes we see these very, very cute Instagram pictures of this super nutritious lunch, but let's be honest, sometimes we only have one hand available and that's all we have. So you're breastfeeding here, you're wiping a butt here, and like, you just don't have enough hands to eat something super nutritious. And hands-on, like a salad, which would be great, but it's not feasible. So I really love wraps and sandwiches because they can be as simple as peanut butter and jelly, where you're getting your fats and you're getting some protein, depending on what, if you're using like an almond butter or a peanut butter, you know, you get your fats there along with your protein. Or if you want to do some kind of like meat and cheese and lettuce, you can add tomatoes. You can make it fancier if you have more time, or it can be super simple, just like a peanut butter and jelly. So we can eat it with one hand, and it's a great option. So never think that we have to overcomplicate things. There's ways you can get the needed calories and different food groups just with a sandwich or a wrap. By the way, if you want to hear other like tips and tricks like this, I do have like a weekly email. I try not to fill your inbox with junk. I want to be helpful. So I did put a link below though to get onto my email list if you are at all interested in getting more tips and tricks to your inbox weekly, or I would say it's about every other week. The next thing that I think is moving on to like a dinner or a bigger meal. Here are 2 things that are just kind of like off the wall things that I think are super easy, and hopefully you will too. The one is a jambalaya type of thing. So I just buy a package of jambalaya mix, like so rice, and it has the seasoning and everything in it. And then I add sausage. You could add chicken or other kinds of meat to it as well. And then I like to cook a vegetable with it. So broccoli for me is the easiest because it doesn't take a lot of prep time. And I have like a steamer pot that goes right on top of the rice pot. And I think total it takes like 15 minutes or something. So here's my rice and sausage pot. And here's my broccoli pot on top. And it's all done, ready to eat in 15 minutes. You've got a meat, you've got your grains, you've got your vegetable. And it's overall pretty filling. So that is another great option for a dinner time meal. And the fifth thing that I recently discovered is spaghetti squash. So if you've never had it before, it's like a yellow vegetable. And if you've just tried to eat it without using it like a noodle, you were probably like, this is the grossest squash ever. It's so stringy. But it's meant to be that way because the way you eat it is you like scrape it out with a fork and it's like a noodle substitute kind of. But the trick with spaghetti squash, because I used to cook it in the oven, and that takes like anywhere from like 45 minutes to sometimes it would take like over an hour to get it to the right consistency. And especially in these summer months, like I don't want my house being heated by my oven for over an hour. Instant pot. The simplest thing, you add a cup of water, you cut your spaghetti squash in half, you spoon out all the seeds in the middle, and you turn the pot on for 5 minutes. Now obviously with the Instant Pot, if you've ever used them before, it does take longer than 5 minutes because it has to get to the right pressure and then it cooks for 5 minutes. But still, maybe like 15, 20 minutes at the most compared to 45 minutes to an hour in the oven. So this is great. So it can be as simple as, okay, you're gonna cook up like a sauce with it and put it on top like spaghetti. Or I recently discovered a nacho recipe. So you cook up taco meat and season it like taco meat. You can add avocado, you can add black beans. I put like a plain Greek yogurt in substitute for sour cream, but you could use sour cream. You shred some cheese, whatever you want. And it is delicious. Like, especially if you're a guacamole person and you add that, it's so good. Even my toddler will eat it. Not all together, but if you disguise it just right and you cut it and stir it, he will eat it. So these are just a few hopefully unique things that you hadn't thought about, ways that you can get the nutrition that you need, but yet you can still take care of your family, which is your main job right now. So hopefully you found that helpful. If you did, please give me a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and I put out videos every single week to help moms with common problems like this. So check it out if that's something that interests you.